Mauricio Suleiman.
Thank you, Mike. We will get to President Suleiman shortly. First, let's go now to another boxing legend joining us tonight. He's done as much in the ring as outside the ring, as a professional, as a humanitarian. He is the pride of East LA, six-time, six-division, 10-time world champion. Please welcome now to the microphone, the Golden Boy, Oscar De La Hoya.
Thank you. Gracias, gracias. Gracias. Thank you very much for everybody who's attending. It's incredible to see all these great champions.
I was expressing to my father-in-law that I'm 48 years old, and until I was 46, I didn't feel like these guys are normal people. I never thought of these people just being like me. I always thought of these guys, I looked at them as gods. These guys were very special because all their accomplishments were very special. And still to this day, to be in the presence of these fighters, to watch their pigs, I had the opportunity to meet the great Carlos Rondon's daughter, and I realized when I'm into my own head and I'm into my ego and I'm telling myself I'm the greatest fighter that ever lived, and I'm in the presence of these people, I would never be here if it wasn't for Roberto the Man, because I didn't even know if I wanted to be a fighter. And then I saw Roberto Duran fight Sugar Ray Leonard in 1980, it was June 20th, and I decided this is what I'm going to do with my life, I'm going to be a fighter. And I always said, if it wasn't for these guys, I wouldn't be here. And I realized I really don't know what I was doing when I was in the presence of these great fighters. You watch guys like Chavez go 90 fights without being defeated. Those are one of the records that stand forever. And I'm really grateful to be in the presence of these people. And then once again, WBC has always been known and been pervasive throughout the years to have the most elaborate get-together in the convention. There's no convention I've ever been to with any organization, WBC, IBF, the WBC always reigns supreme. And it's able to tell by the presence here tonight. We also had the opportunity not only witnessed the great Muhammad Ali, but we also watched his daughter climb the heights of success and greatness in boxing as well, become one of the greatest fist-to-cuff women fighters the world has ever seen. And that's just credit to the great genes of Muhammad Ali. And then once again, none of this would ever happen tonight. All of this entails the greatness of Don Jose Suleiman. Without Mr. Suleiman, this would never happen. I believe he took part in possessing the WBC in what, 1963? 1963, the WBC was inoculated into the world. And ever since then, we had the greatest fight that the fight world has ever known. From now on until the end of the time, the WBC will always reign supreme. We always had the best champion, we also always had the best fight, and we also made sure we paid our dues on time too, right?